Hello, and welcome to the TI Precision Lab video discussing ratiometric measurements for temperature sensors. In this video, we shall understand what a ratiometric measurement means for temperature sensors and how it can be implemented using simple circuits. A sensor is used to convert a physical signal or input into an electrical signal. A signal conditioning circuit then converts the electrical signal into an output, which can be used by an MCU for processing. The measurement of the physical input, though not affected by any other signal, can still be impacted by external variances, such as a power supply. As a result, the output of the sensor may change in relation to the variation. In a ratiometric measurement, the conditioning of the signal is done with respect to the external variances as a reference signal, instead of an absolute source. This means that the signal of interest is measured with respect to another signal to which it is proportionally correlated. Using ratiometric measurements, changes from being an independent voltage or current to a component with much tighter tolerances. A simple example of this is a resistor. To illustrate the concept better, let us consider a case with a thermistor as our temperature sensor, biased with a voltage-controlled current source, VCCS. The current source is specified as alpha times VCC, where VCC is the supply voltage. The thermistor's output is applied to the non-inverting input of the op amp and can be calculated as the current times the resistance of the thermistor. The gain of the non-inverting amplifier circuit can be calculated as shown. Now the output of the circuit can be simplified to this equation. By doing some basic math, the relationship between the supply voltage variation and the output signal can be derived. So as the supply voltage variation increases, the output increases. Similarly, with the supply voltage variation decreasing, the output variation decreases. As already seen in the previous circuit, the relationship between supply and the output is linear and directly proportional. At the same time, our signal of interest is the RT and not VCC, so one can simply use the ratiometric measurement approach to cancel out the dependency of the supply voltage variation on the output. To do so, we use the ADC as a signal conditioning circuit. For an ADC, the relationship between input and output is specified as shown. By connecting the VCC as the reference voltage, the output of the op-amp circuit as the input of the ADC, the relationship between input and output may be simplified as shown. Our system is now measuring the ratio of V-amp and VCC, which is equivalent to the direct measurement of RT. Further simplification shows that the external variation brought by VCC is no longer a part of the equation, thus establishing a ratiometric measurement. In this circuit, the output signal across the thermistor is fed into an analog-to-digital converter for signal conditioning and data communication. The output of an ADC can be summarized in the equation shown. Although this seems to be a simple method of biasing the thermistor, it can suffer from reference supply variation and introduce potential measurement error. Since the output signal is directly proportional to the VN over VREF value, the ratiometric method can be used to cancel out the reference voltage variation on the output, as shown in the updated circuit. In this ratiometric circuit, the reference voltage is generated with the same current source as the input voltage. Simplifying the equation reduces it to a ratio of the thermistor resistance and the reference resistance. Now the circuit is independent of both the VREF voltage source tolerance and the current source drift mismatch. In the next example, we take a Wheatstone bridge, which is commonly used to measure strain, load, pressure, and temperature. As given in the equation, the measurement is done across the voltage points VH and VL. Any variation in our sense will introduce a voltage change across VH and VL. Furthermore, there is a linear relationship between the sense voltage and VCC. Therefore, this circuit is susceptible to external variations in VCC and can be reconfigured using the ratiometric method to negate the effect of the varying supply voltage on the sensor measurement error. To cancel out the effect of VCC, we utilize the VCC for our ADC reference supply. By doing this, the ratio between VSense and VCC will make RSense the only variable in the measurement. Therefore, the accuracy of the measuring system in this case becomes a function of the passive components used in the bridge. To summarize, In this video, we learn that measuring systems can be affected by external variations resulting in errors. With a ratiometric approach, it is possible to eliminate the effects of varying conditions on the sensor accuracy with minimal effect. At the same time, it is easier to control the tolerances of components that a ratiometric system uses than some conventional methods. Thank you for watching this video on ratiometric measurements.